So, GPT 4.1 just dropped. It's faster, cheaper, and way smarter than its predecessor 4.0. But there's a caveat. It's API only. In today's video, I'll let you in on GPT 4.1's new features, put it head-to-head with Claude 3.7 Sonnet and GPT 4.0, and test how they handle real-world coding tasks. We'll see how their reasoning stacks up, check out their performance on AI benchmarks, and even look at their input context window length. Stick around because you won't want to miss this showdown. Let's get into it. GPT 4.1 is OpenAI's new flagship model, but is unavailable through the usual ChatGPT interface. Nope, this time it's all about the API. Why is it that way? It's because this model is a toolbox for developers called DevTools, especially those into coding. Launched on April 14, 2025, GPT 4.1 is OpenAI's latest move in the ongoing AI showdown. Unlike earlier versions that aimed to be everything to everyone, GPT 4.1 is clear about its main goal. It's designed for developers. It has coding skills and can follow instructions better than the earlier models. Hold on, there's more to this release. GPT 4.1 comes with two new variants, GPT 4.1 Mini and GPT 4.1 Nano. While GPT 4.1 is already more affordable than its predecessor, GPT 4.0, the mini version is a steal at just 42 cents per million tokens. But wait for it, the nano model is cheaper at only 12 cents. That makes it OpenAI's fastest and most budget-friendly model yet. And guess what? It still outperforms GPT 4.0 and GPT 4.0 Mini in high-volume coding tasks. That brings us to Claude 3.7 Sonnet. This bad boy is Anthropic's latest brainchild, nicknamed the Transparent Thinker, and it hit the scene on February 24, 2025. What's cool about this version is that it introduces a hybrid reasoning model. First of its kind, and it offers quick responses and extended step-by-step thinking, all within a single model. Claude 3.7 Sonnet can generate near-instant answers or solve complex problems with detailed, user-visible reasoning. This allows for a balance between speed and depth in its responses. But the real game changer? Transparency. Claude can show you how it thinks, like peeling back the layers to reveal its thought process. You get a sneak peek at how its brain works in real time. Alright, it's time to compare both AI models and see how they stack up against each other. Let's talk about the input context window for a second. It's a fancy way of saying how much information these AI models can handle. GPT 4.0 Turbo and GPT 4.0 have a 128,000 token context window, while the original GPT 4.0 model has 32,000. Now, Claude 3.7 Sonnet has a limit of 200,000 tokens, while GPT 4.1 goes all out with an incredible capacity of 1 million tokens. You might be wondering what that even means in real-life terms, right? Tokens are like chunks of text. The more tokens a model can manage, the more it can process in one go. So, GPT 4.1 can keep track of more details and context than Claude 3.7 Sonnet. This makes a big difference if you're trying to have a deep conversation or need lots of information at once. More tokens mean more room for ideas to flow. Moving on to maximum output tokens, which is how much context these models can generate in one go. The GPT 4.0 and GPT 4.0 Turbo models have a maximum output token limit of 4,096. They can generate a response with up to 4,096 tokens. Meanwhile, Claude 3.7 Sonnet generates 128,000 tokens in a single request. GPT 4.1 has a smaller limit of 32,768 tokens. The more tokens a model can generate, the longer and more detailed the response. So with Claude's high limit, you could get more information or an entire story compared to what GPT can provide. It's similar to a friend telling you a complete story versus another who gives a quick summary. Interesting, right? Wait until you see how up-to-date their responses are. Are you enjoying the video? Then give it a thumbs up. I'd also appreciate it if you subscribe to this channel. Also, hit the notification bell so you never miss our latest updates. Let's get back to the showdown. Now, what's the knowledge cutoff date? Well, it points to when a model's info stops. For instance, Claude 3.7 Sonnet wrapped up its updates in April 2024, while GPT 4.1 held on a bit longer with its last update in June 2024. See it as having a smartphone that can only download apps until a specific date. After that, you miss out on all the cool new stuff that comes afterward. It boils down to how up-to-date the information is that these models can share. If you're looking for the latest trends or recent news, the one with the later cutoff, GPT 4.1, has more current info. Okay, let's not forget the pricing details. Claude 3.7 Sonnet comes in at $3 for every million tokens. On the other hand, GPT 4.1 is a bit more budget-friendly at $2 per million tokens, 33% less. Now, if we switch gears to the cost of the output tokens generated by these models, it's a different story. Claude 3.7 Sonnet charges a hefty $15 for each million tokens, while GPT 4.1 is much easier on the wallet at just $8 per million. So when you do the math, it's clear that GPT 4.1 is the more affordable choice overall. Moving on, how does each model approach reasoning? GPT 4.1 is a super helpful assistant who knows how to follow instructions. This thing can tackle complicated tasks with an impressive level of accuracy. It's like a senior developer on your team who takes the time to read through a project's details before jumping into the coding part. You know, instead of just skimming through it and making random guesses. That makes it so handy, especially when dealing with tricky technical stuff where every little detail counts. On the flip side, we have Claude 3.7 Sonnet. One of the cool things about it is that it's a transparent reasoner. It can switch between giving you standard answers and this extended thinking mode. In this mode, you get to see how it's thinking through stuff. It's a coding buddy who talks through their thought process out loud. This way, if there's any flaw in the logic, you can catch it before it leads to any messy code. That's neat if you ask me. For developers, the real value of these models is all about how well they can code. When we think about what makes them helpful, their coding skills truly stand out. I've been exploring AI coding tools, and I must say, GPT 4.1 is great. It's good at generating clean and straightforward front-end code, which is helpful. Plus, it excels at spotting what to fix in existing code bases. I saw a comparison between GPT 4.1 and Claude 3.7, where they reviewed 200 pull requests side by side. Guess what? GPT 4.1 came out on top in about 55% of the cases. It made fewer unnecessary suggestions and was way better at catching bugs. Similarly, Claude 3.7 Sonnet has also stepped up its game at coding, especially in front-end web development. It's as if Anthropic looked at its predecessor and said, "Let's make this way better." They rolled out a coding agent called Claude Code, which is a command line tool that helps with coding tasks in a more hands-on way. This shows they're not just playing around, they're looking to make a mark in the developer tools landscape. Okay, how do these models perform on AI benchmarks? First off, let's look at MMLU, the Massive Multitask Language Understanding Benchmark. This evaluation's interesting because it tests knowledge across 57 subjects, like math, history, law, etc. GPT 4.1 came out on top with an impressive 90.2%. Meanwhile, Claude 3.7 Sonnet scored 80%. So it's clear that GPT 4.1 is the winner in this round. Next is the GPQA, or Graduate Level Physics Question Assessment, a test that examines advanced physics knowledge with complex questions. Think of them as diamond science level challenges. GPT 4.1 led with a score of 87.3%. Not too shabby, right? Meanwhile, Claude 3.7 Sonnet gave it a good run, scoring 84.8% in the extended thinking mode. But when it switched to standard mode, its score dropped to around 78.2%. So once again, it looks like GPT 4.1 is taking the lead in this competition. What about the SWE Bench Verified benchmark? This cool test checks how well different AI models can tackle software engineering problems by looking at their code modifications and custom agent setups. In this round, GPT 4.1 managed to score a decent 54.6%. But guess what? Claude 3.7 Sonnet crushed it with a score of 70.3% when it was using a custom scaffold. Even without that fancy setup, it came in strong at 62.3%. Seems Claude 3.7 Sonnet is the winner when it comes to coding. And that's it for the showdown between these two giant closed-source models. So which model do you think is the best among the two, GPT 4.1 or Claude 3.7 Sonnet? Let me know in the comments below. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell for more content. Catch you in the next one.